It's time for Rockport High School basketball here on WZOT. And now, all of the action.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to The Rock for tonight's contest between the Lady Jackets and the Lady Blue Devils of Model, as Lady Jackets come in running riding a three-game win streak. I'm Jeff Sharp, joined by Chris Wolf, and Chris, good to see you again.
Yeah, this week.
Yeah, hey, we got another one tomorrow. We got another one tomorrow night. So
I made it on time.
They didn't change the time on us this time. So I want to remind everybody tomorrow, 5 o'clock, we'll be right back here at the Rock. Got two JV games starting at 2 o'clock. So as Cedartown comes in, Cedartown's got to make a ride to Central of Carroll tonight. So they're going there, and then they'll be here tomorrow. They've had a long road. They had to go to Troop County earlier this week. Had another road game. Then they had a makeup game they had to make up. So Cedartown's going to be worn out when they come in here.
They definitely got some long away games headed up west Georgia, I guess you'd say.
So want to remind everybody, we got the boys game right after this, and a huge, huge boys game tonight as the Jackets are taking on the Blue Devils, and this is a battle between one and the first place team Model. They're tied with Chattooga, and then our boys are in third place, just a game behind them. So it's a huge game for the boys tonight to get a win against Model. But before that, we've got the Lady Jackets taking on the Lady Blue Devils of Model on December 13th. We went there and defeated them 55-49, and Model has always been in the top of the region, but not this year. They're sitting in fifth place. They're 5-6, 9-12 on the year. They score 49 a game. They give up 49 a game. And the Lady Jackets come in ranked 11th in the state, according to Max Preps, 9-2 in region play, 14-6. We scored just over 51, allow 45, but in region play, we've got the best defense in the region and the third best offense behind Gordon Central and Chattooga, who have outscored us by about 40, but we only allow 40 points a game in region, so which is Dade County's the next closest to that. So Lady Jackets doing it defensively. They're quick. They move around. They get a lot of steals, and then those steals lead to a lot of fast break points with Kiara Berry and Megan Little leading the way.
Yep, and we saw them change a little bit up the other night, you know, with moving Kiara towards the middle some and let some things happen for Megan Little. So, you know, that's a huge key, too, is not only Kiara scoring, but what she does to the opposing defense.
Yeah, and last time we went up there, like we said, we won up there, but the Lady Blue Devils had Montana Moat. She had 26 points, so we're going to have to – she's number 24, so if we get a chance to find her, I think she's going to be the big girl over there across the floor from us. And, you know, she probably did, you know, got her points inside, if I had to guess.
Yeah,
we do a pretty good job on the perimeter as Model getting there, running their offense, getting some shots going right now. So Model is always tough, and they're always in the game. They're just not having quite the year that they expect there, but I'm sure they'll get that turned around. Hopefully not tonight, though.
Yeah, the one you pointed out, you know, she's about the only size they've got. Everybody else is either average or even a little short, you could say, compared to, you know, our starting five.
Yeah, without a doubt. And, you know, with Kiara down, you know, if she plays down low, she'll be able to match her up physically and be able to jump and stay with her and be able to play inside. And Bria Daniels and Emma Evans, they're going to have their work cut out for them as, you know, they're going to have to handle her inside.
Yeah, you know, and I think those two have gotten better over the last few games. So they've definitely gotten better. As far as playing that middle, playing under the basket, they've been really tough and really making a lot of things happen down there.
Yeah, like we said, Chattooga's in first place, 10-1. We're at 9-2, second place. And we've got this game tonight. We've got our Murchie on Tuesday, and then senior night next Friday night right here as Pusa comes in. And really all we have to do is win one of the next three region games, and we've got that two seed locked up. Automatic bid into the state playoffs. And very important, because in the region tournament, that means you get a double bye.
Yeah, you want to win it, but you definitely want to finish in the top two and jump in there and have that automatic bid.
So other games around the region, Chautauqua is at Coosa, Gordon Central at Armurchie, and Pepperell at Dade County. And, we're really hoping we can win out. Chautauqua somehow drops two games and we can get a one seed, which would be great, because then the region tournament is right here. And that would be nice, and not have to ride up to Chautauqua several times for the boys and the girls. But we'll see how everything plays out. And you know what? If we got to go on the road, we'll just do what we got to do. And I know Coach Clark and his young ladies are ready to go since that trip up to Chautauqua. They've won three in a row and really playing some good basketball, as two of the last three opponents, they've held to 23 points.
Yeah.
One of them, it was 36, which was at Gordon Central, which is the third-place team in the region.
And we did a lot better job the last couple of games of scoring early in the first period and second period. You know, we've definitely struggled there. I remember one game, I think we only scored five in the first period, so I think the other night we might have hit 18 or so. So 17 looks like.
So Pierre Berry, of course, leading the Lady Jackets with just over 30 points a game. Megan Little comes in. Her average keeps climbing every game, as she's up to 11.5. And then you got Ambria Daniels and Emma Evans doing things on the boards as they average 6 and 7 rebounds apiece. So we're going to take a two-minute break, and we'll be right back as we're going to try and get our starters ready to go. We'll talk a little bit more leading up to this game, and we know the crowd's already feisty from the JV game that just finished up, and they're starting to file in. Model side looking good. They brought their radio. They're sitting kind of catty corner too, is up in that corner. Of course, we know Cedar Town's radio crew will be here tomorrow night as well. They're going to set up in that same area. And we got our same courtside seats right here above the scorer's table, and just a great place to watch the game for us. So we're going to take 2 minutes, and then we'll be right back, get ready for the national anthem and the starters. So we'll be back after this.
WZOT Rottmark, W270CE Rome.
At Century Bank of Georgia's Rockmart office, you'll find the reassuring blend of responsive, personal service with a wide array of accounts, technologies, loans, and more. And you'll find each delivered by a bank professional whose goal is to exceed your expectations of what a bank can be. We invite you to discover all we are today. Your local choice for community banking. Go Jackets! Century Bank of Georgia. Rockmart. We want to be your bank. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Who has time for laundry? R&W's Laundry, the cleanest laundromat in Northwest Georgia, is a full service 7 days a week laundromat with state-of-the-art washers and dryers. Don't want to wash? Let our friendly staff do it for you. Ball teams, churches, restaurants, and even wedding services are welcome to come to R&W's Laundry, proud sponsor of Jacket Basketball, located at 804 West Elm Street, Rockmart. And go Jackets.
Your personal information is very important, and when compromised, can lead to big security issues. Don't trust your information with a here today, gone tomorrow company. Call somebody with reliability and stability in this community. Barnes Tax Service, 770-684-7556.
Are you aware that untreated wood is highly susceptible to termite damage? Are you bothered by other pesky insects like bed bugs, ants, roaches, wasps, and hornets? Call Harrelson Termite and Pest Control for an inspection. They have the experience to handle your pest control needs. Call Harrelson Termite and Pest Control today to schedule an appointment.
Silver Comet Furniture, your one-stop shop for all your furniture and bedding needs. We carry brands such as Ashley, Catnapper, Liberty, and Jameson Mattress Company. That's Silver Comet Furniture, 678-685-4320. 2000 Cedartown Highway in Fish Creek.
Now, more of Rottmart High School basketball here on WZOT.
April. All right, we're back at the Rock. 2.5 minutes to go before tip-off. As we've got our starters ready. Last time the Lady Blue Devils and the Lady Jackets went at it at Model. Of course, Rottmart came away with a 55-49 victory. But the Lady Blue Devils were led by Montana Moats with 26 points, 13 rebounds. And Nia Allen, the point guard, 10 points, 5 rebounds, and she had 4 steals. But we were paced by Tierra Berry, and Megan Little was still playing at that time. And that was before she went down with her knee injury. And since Megan's come back, we've really done it with Tierra, you know, cutting inside. And like you said the other night, we put her inside, and it opened up things for Megan outside shooting the three.
And Kiara was still able to, you know, get hers too as well, working in the inside. Plus, you know, she still got her outside shots too.
Yeah, and the other thing that I've noticed the past few games is we're shooting a lot better from outside with our threes, where before we were shooting a lot of threes and not making a lot. Now we're shooting, we're not shooting near as many threes, but we are making more threes than we were in the past. And a lot of that is because, you know, you've got the inside play of Ambria Daniels and Emma Evans, but they get it inside, and then you kick it back out to Megan, Kiara, and some of the others that they can shoot from the outside, and they're knocking down those wide-open threes.
Yep, and taking advantage of what's been given to them, you know, by the defense having to focus on other things. So hopefully they can keep shooting tonight and stay hot.
Yeah, we all want to remind you, we'll be joined at halftime by Coach Vic Calhoun of the boys, and he'll talk about the big game that they have tonight with the Model Blue Devils. But before that, we're getting ready for the national anthem, starting lineups as the girls are starting to clear the floor. And like I said, I want to remind you that the ladies are one win away from locking up that 2 seed. And automatically making it into the playoffs. Now, it doesn't guarantee what seed they're going to be, but you're going to be somewhere 1 through 4.
Yep.
All right, we're going to take 2 minutes, get the national anthem going, and we'll be back with our starting lineups and tip-off.
Is your thermostat breaking your wallet each month? The reason could be your home is not adequately insulated. Have the experts at TNT Insulation help put money back in your pocket. Call Tim Montgomery today at 770-684-1887 to schedule an inspection. TNT Insulation can handle all your insulation needs, and they specialize in spray foam insulation.
Get your bronze on. Visit Totally Bronze Tanning Salon at 254 West Elm Street in Brockmart to get that beautiful bronze look. Totally Bronze Tanning Salon has a very clean and cool facility with a safe, well-lit parking area. For a quick tan, they have sunless spray tanning. Call them today at 770-684-3003 for an appointment, or go by 254 West Elm Street in Brockmart.
Buy low, true value. 308 Nathan Dean Parkway in Brockmart invites you to come by and watch the inventory grow every day. We're the home of the Garrett Brothers Sawmill. Our family has been processing and selling our country's greatest renewable resources for over 100 years. Like us on Facebook or give us a call at 770-684-5075.
What kind of cake will they serve at your retirement party? Chocolate? Red velvet? Well, go ahead and call the bakery, because whether you plan to retire in 15 years or 50, a State Farm agent can help you take charge of your retirement and help make it seem like, well,
a piece of cake.
Sherman Ross State Farm Insurance, 122 East Elm Street in Rockmart. Call 770-684-3500. Email him at sherman@shermanross.net. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Neither State Farm nor its agents provide tax, legal, or investment advice. Consult your own advisor regarding your particular circumstances.
Freeman Harris Funeral Home, the funeral home that has been providing a strong arm for our friends and neighbors to lean on for the past 76 years. We are proud of the young folks of our community and wish for them success on the field and off. Freeman Harris Funeral Home, Rockmart's very own.
Now, more of Rockmart High School basketball here on WZOT.
All right, we're back at the Rock as the national anthem is just played. Now we're getting ready for our starting lineups. I'm going to turn it over to Chris Wolf as he gives you the starting lineups for tonight.
Yep, for the Model Blue Devils, number 4, Nia Allen. Number 11, Avery Quarles. Number 15, Brooke Roberts. Number 24, Montana Moats. And number 32, Madison Moats.
All right, like I said, so 15 is Brooke Roberts. That's not the one that has so many. 24, Montana Moats. She's going to be the shooting guard So I'm going to say we're going to have to have our work cut out for us starting the three.
So starting lineup for our Lady Jackets. Sophomore forward, number 10, Brandy Jones. Junior at the guard, number 11, Megan Little. Junior forward, Kiera Berry. Senior center, Andrea Daniels. And a senior at the post position, number 32, Emma Evans.
All right, we're back. The crowd is still filing in. They're standing up in the end zones here. And
leaving the restaurants and making their way this way.
Yep, we got the student section roped off down there tonight. And so we got Miss Leslie Adams. She usually sits up at the top. She's right behind us tonight. You got here late.
Right.
You'll be on. Brian, you might. She's saying, Brian, you might want to have that 5 second delay.
Yeah, plenty of dump going.
All right, we're getting ready to go. Brooke Roberts and Kiera Berry are going to jump it off here.
Roberts has definitely got the hype advantage on Kiera, but I'd be surprised if she's got the jumping advantage on her. We'll see.
All right, three-man crew, and it is a true three-man crew. Kiera Berry wins the tip, right back to Megan Little. We're going to set things up here as the Lady Blue Devils come out in a man. Ambria Daniels, 10-footer on the way, no good. Rebounded by Roberts. She gives it to Allen, and now she's moving it down the court. And it looks like we're going to be in, let's see, we're going to get set up here. Megan Little is on Nia Allen. We're in a man as well. So both teams, man-to-man defense has started out. Let's see who's on 24.
Look here.
And there's a steal. Ambria Daniels knocked it out of the hand to Roberts. Emma Evans picks it up. She gets it to Kiera. Moats is on Kiera on defense. So now Kiera set up at the free throw line. Three ball. Emma Evans on the way. No good off the front iron. Rebounded by Daniels. She puts it back in, and she scores. Lady Jackets on the board first. 2-0. 1 minute into the game.
There's that big play by Daniels up under the goal there, like we've been talking about.
That offensive rebound, huge for the Lady Jackets. Allen has it, comes down the lane.
Ooh.
Oh, and Kiera Berry's going to pick up a foul as she reached in for the ball and grabbed Nia by the, it's going to be on 22, Ambria Daniels. Kiera picked up a break there.
Boy.
So, Ambria must have got her with the body. Got it on. Well, Andre, don't argue that.
No, we'll.
He's trying. Nia Allen at the free throw line as she makes the first free throw. I kind of thought that was on the floor, but they caught it on Ambria instead of Kiera. We'll take that as she misses that one. Ambria with the rebound. I think he might be happy now. Evans gets it inside to Berry. She dribbles, goes right down the lane, and lays it in. A little finger roll as Moats went for the steal and left Kiera all alone.
Yeah, that's a good game plan right there.
Madison Moats.
Another steal by Daniels.
Andrea Daniels knocks it away. Evans gets it. Kiera on the way. Misses the layup as Quarles kind of bumped her a little bit and just threw her off balance to where she missed the shot.
Yeah, she got there and just checked her just a little bit to throw her off her pace.
Now Nia Allen with the ball, guarded by Megan Little, and Kiera got a hand on it as Emma Evans tried to save the ball, but she stepped out of bounds. Nia missed the shot, and Brooke Roberts knocked it away from Ambria. So we lead 4-1, 2 minutes into the game. They get it inside quickly to Madison Moats. She hits the bottom of the backboard, rebounded by Evans. Berry has it. Ooh, close to the backcourt. Three ball by Megan Little. It's the front iron, the backboard, it goes in, and it's 7-1. Lady Jackets with the lead, and we need to keep this lead, keep that model crowd silent. Quarles goes around Evans, gets it to Montana Moats. Madison Moats has it. Brandy Jones is on it. Brandy Jones is going to pick up a foul. And Madison Moats is going to go through the line to shoot two. So that's our second team foul. Kiara's working out that shoulder. She's complaining with that shoulder last Thursday. And Moats makes the first one. So we've got Madison Moats and Montana Moats on the floor. Second free throw is good. It's 7-3.
Yeah, that's an area for concern there with Kiara, the way she's rubbing and trying to keep that shoulder moving.
Megan Little has it. Gives it up to Jones, then to Daniels, then to Evan. Kiara trying to work inside around the free throw line. Brandy Jones, three ball on the way. No good off the back iron. And good job of Emma Evans as she grabbed the ball, threw it off the shin of Nia Allen out of bounds. She couldn't save it, but she could get a hand on it.
Great heads up play right there by Emma Evans.
Megan Little gets it into Evans. Right back to Little. Three ball on the way. Oh, in and out. No good. Rebounded by Roberts. Stolen by Daniels.
She's hauling. Hey,
oh,
I got
go
the
to
ball.
The ball. You had it. Oh, she didn't want to dribble. Evans, guys, I think she may have thought she had already dribbled. Then a steal by Montana Moses. Little threw it right to her. Trying to get it to Jones. Barry is on Montana Moses, who had 26 against us last time. Megan Little's on Nia Allen, who had 10. And that's going to be a jump ball. Good job by Ambria Daniels tying up Allen. And it's going to go to Model underneath their own goal as they're shooting to the goal to our right.
That's a rough way to get a jump ball right there.
Moats throws it into Moats. She dribbles left-handed, not very well. Gets it to Allen, cutting down the lane. Runs into a brick wall, and Ambria Daniels, a great job getting her hand on top of the ball. Another jump ball.
She had the ball. Girl couldn't move with it. Ambria just so strong.
So now we get the ball. Our turn. So Little throws it into Barry. Back to Little. She brings it down. Daniels had a screen. Little kicks it back to Evans. Trying to get it inside as three of them converge on Kiara. Kiara's in the lane now. And Bria Daniels, three ball on the way. No good. Back iron. Rebounded by Montana Moats, and she's off and running, and then she slows it down once she gets across half court.
Yeah, Coach going to have to figure out what we're going to do with that triple team, and that leaves two people open.
Montana Moats, 30-footer on the way. No good. Rebound by Emma Evans. Gives it up to Little. She brings it across. Good screen set by Barry. Then to Daniels. Gets it to Barry. 15-footer. No good. Rebounded by Roberts. Kiara with a shot about one step inside the three-point line. Hey, I'd rather take a step back and shoot that three. Moats with a three. No good. Rebounded by Jones. So we're doing a pretty good job on the glass as Coach Clark is going to call a 60-second timeout. We lead 7-3, 3:37 to go first quarter. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
Hey, Jacket fans, this is your old buddy Bill Shervesy, general manager of All-Star Motors here in Rockmart. At All-Star, we offer late-model pre-owned vehicles with guaranteed credit approval. Come drive your new pre-owned vehicle home today. That's right, today. Visit our web at www.allstarmotorco.com. We have that unforgettable phone number, 770-684-CARS. Remember, All-Star Motors, where every day is an all-star day, and go Jackets.
A-Plus Store Solutions is your local Weaver's Portable Building and R&B Metal Structures dealer in Rockmart. We also sell dock kennels and a variety of trailers, including dump trailers. Get your portable building faster at A-Plus Store Solutions. We are located just a half mile south of Rockmart High School on Highway 113. Stop by and see Jim or give us a call at 678-883-2006.
Now, more of Rockmart High School basketball here on WZOT.
All right, we're back at the Rock. Coach Clark got a 60-second timeout. Gives the ladies a chance to get a breather here. Set up for maybe it looks like a different offense now. Oh, great cut by Brandy Jones. Emma Evans with a great pass, and Jones just couldn't handle it. Right on the baseline underneath the goal. If Brandy can catch that ball, she just lays it in.
Puts it right in.
So turnover by the Lady Jackets. Model has the ball. Allen throws it to Quarles on the right side. She's guarded by Evans. Still man-to-man. Has a screen set for Montana Moats. Kiara didn't follow her, and Moats a little floater in the lane at 7-5.
Well, we held her off for almost 5 minutes there.
Well, I'm sure she's going to be dangerous from the outside. And Bria has it, top of the tee, gets it over to Little. Jones cutting down the lane, floater no good, and rebounded by Allen. And then Emma Evans going to pick up a foul as she reached in, knocked it away. So that's our third team foul?
Yes, sir.
And I don't think Models has any yet, do they?
Nope.
So 7-5, 2:42 to go first quarter. Still in a man. Everybody down low. Allen drives in, misses the shot. Rebounded Megan Little. She's off and running. Her and Kiera, 2-on-3. Allen knocks it away from her, and it's out of bounds, and it'll be our ball as we're shooting to the goal to our left here in this first half. 2:27 to go. Megan's going to throw it in. Megan gets it into Kiera. Nia Allen's on her now. So Nia probably a little bit quicker than most. Daniel sets the screen. Kiera double team, gets it to Jones. Three ball, Ambria. No good off the side of the iron. Rebounded by Quarles. Quarles gets it to Allen. She's going to bring it down the floor. Over to Montana Moats. Gets it inside to Roberts. And another knock. Ambria knocks it away. Got it to Brandi Jones. Jones to Kiera. She dives in, lays it in with the right hand on the left side, and scores. It's 9-5.
Very good shot. We might see Kiera get her first period break right here.
Yeah, with a four-point lead as Logan Adams set to come in. And that's going to be a moving screen on Brooke Roberts. And that's the first foul on the Model Lady Blue Devils. Ambria Daniels going to go to the bench. Yeah, still not quite there. No, we got to get to that one-minute mark before Kiera gets that breather. And she may not tonight with it still being 9-5. Megan's going to bring it down. Logan Adams wide open. Three ball on the way. Oh, off the back iron, no good. Rebounded by Twilly of Model. She gets it to Moats all the way across to her sister. And no good on the three. Rebounded by Evans. Megan Little has it now. As Madison Moats harasses her in the backcourt. Megan loses her, gets down the lane. And Brandi Jones wide open on the baseline, but knocked away by Nia Allen out of bounds. 1:14 to go first quarter.
Yeah, it was a good look right there by Megan. Unfortunately, Allen closed that gap quick.
All right, Megan gets it in to Brandi Jones out near half court. Back to Megan. Three ball on the way. A little bit too hard. Back iron, no good. Rebounded by Madison Moats. She gets it to Allen very quickly down the floor as she missed Colburn cutting to the basket, and it goes out of bounds. So good try by Allen, but Colburn just a little bit low, and Colburn couldn't handle it.
Yeah, tough pass right there.
All right, under a minute. We're up 9-5. Little over to Adams on the left side. Kiera comes in. She gets it. Montana Moats is on her. Little sets the screen. Barry goes around it. Step back three on the way. No good. And Colburn knocks it away from Evans. And Allen comes down with it. 30 seconds to go. Allen drives in. And it's on the floor, but it's going to be a foul on Megan Little. So, Nia Allen, we see her game. She's driving to the basket every time she can.
Yeah, she's definitely a good ball handler, and she's taking it straight to him.
So, it looks like we're still in the man. And if she wants to do that, you may see us break out and get in the zone. There's a steal by Megan Little. She's got it one-on-one with Allen. She takes it in, misses the layup. Rebounded by Allen. 15 seconds to go. Little almost with another steal. She swiped it away from her. Twilly goes around Adams, cuts in over Evans, rolls around, it's good. Six, hurry up and throw it in. Get it down the floor. Four, three, half-court shot. Megan Little is going to be short. It's 9-7, end of the first quarter. We'll be back right after this.
Our kitchen is where our life happens. It wasn't always perfect, but now it is, thanks to a home equity line of credit from Family.
Use the equity in your house to love your home with Family Savings Credit Union. Visit FamilySavingsCU.com.
This is Ryan Robinson, branch manager of your local Family Savings Credit Union. Come by and visit us sometime, 101 Felton Drive, Rockmart, Georgia, 770-684-8601.
Equal Housing Opportunity Member, NCUA, NMLS number 800746.
Here's a real tweet from a real Chick-fil-A guest. Meredith writes,
am I the only person who didn't know Chick-fil-A had mac and cheese? Holy game changer.
The secret's out now, Meredith.
Is there anything you think the world should know about our mac and cheese?
What I really like about the mac and cheese is the oven-toasted, golden brown, cheesy top layer. It's savory, and it makes you feel really good.
That does sound amazing. Thanks, Meredith. Try the mac and cheese yourself at your local Chick-fil-A. Real Chick-fil-A guests paid for their testimonial.
Now, more of Rock Martin High School basketball here on WZOT.
All right, back of the rock. Lady Jags get the ball to open up the second quarter. Little throws it all the way across to Evans. Gets it inside to Jones. She hits the bottom of the backboard, gets her own rebound, puts up another shot, and she gets fouled by Nia Allen, number four. And Brandi Jones going to go to the line to shoot two RW Laundry free throws. Free up your time by taking advantage of RW's wash and fold service laundry and their clean, well-kept laundry.
Model's first foul of the game.
Second. Has one on Roberts right here, the moving screen. Jones misses the first free throw. Second free throw is no good. Allen with a rebound. Allen gets it ahead to Montana Moats. Missed the carry down there right in front of him. And looks like we're still in the man, but Megan Little is on Montana Moats now, and Kiara Berry's on Nia Allen. That may cut Nia off from trying to drive so much. Kiara with her speed and length. Kiara, great job of defense moving her feet. Quarles faked the three, got Kiara in the air, and Brandi Jones knocks it out of bounds as Kiara switched off her man when Allen gave it to Quarles, and Quarles faked the three. They try and get it inside. There's a good job by Emma Evans and a steal. Brandi Jones comes down with it, gets it to Logan Adams, who gets it to Little. Megan's going to bring it down. Model still in the man-to-man defense as well. Over to Adams. Wide open three on the way. He's good! Nothing but net! 12-7. Lady Jackets with the lead. Nia Allen. Brandi Jones picked off Kiara Berry. And then she blocks Roberts' shot. As Allen missed the shot, Roberts' offensive rebound, Kiara blocked it.
That was a nice defensive play right there.
Kiara had to catch up. Oh, my gosh. Megan Little with a bullet pass over the head of Jones. And almost hit Models coach right in the hands. But he missed it. It went through his hands.
That was a rocket.
Allen with the ball. Got it inside to Roberts. Allen cuts to the goal. Kiara cut her off. Quarles with the ball. Wide open. Free throw line. Not shooting. That's 3 seconds. She's still in the lane. They got it to Madison Moat. And she got her own rebound. And she got fouled going up the second time by Brandi Jones. And that's going to be her first personal and 15 foul. Free throw is good by Moats. Emma Evans going to come out, and Bria Daniels goes in. Barry Daniels, Jones, Little, and Adams on the floor for the Lady Jackets. Moats, Roberts, Twilly, and Quarles on the floor for the Lady Blue Devils. Allen takes a seat as Moats makes the second free throw. Megan Little, three ball on the way, a little bit short, and got all net but the outside of the net.
Yeah, just a little short right there.
So she rushed that shot just a little bit as the defender was coming at her. Now, Twilly gives it up to Quarles. Quarles drives in, kicks it out. Most three ball wide open. Splash. It's 12-12. And that is who we cannot leave alone,
leave
Montana Most.
Can't leave her sitting out there by herself. She's going to knock them down.
Now, Barry, Model with a 1-2-2 defense. Barry goes right down the lane, misses the shot. Roberts is going to get called with a foul. She threw an elbow. No, Brandi Jones gets the call, gets the foul. Wow. Roberts threw an elbow down there, and Brandi Jones gets called for the foul. That's her second personal, 16 foul. So now Model will be in the bonus the remainder of the half. 12-12. Twilly brings it down. Gives it up to Madison Moats. Montana Moats cuts in. Megan Little's on her. She dribbles out to the three-point line. Gives it back deep. Three by Madison Moats. No good. Rebounded by Adams. Adams gets it a Little. Now she's going to bring it down. Over to Emma Evans down in the corner. Back to Little. Adams has it, gives it up to Kiera. Kiera has Montana Moats on her, gives it a Little, top of the key. Kiera moves inside. Moats goes for a steal, misses. Kiera bumps into Roberts. Fadeaway is good in the lane, and it's 14-12. Now we're in a 1-2-2. No, we're not. We're still in a man. Kiera is following Twilly around. As Megan Little has Moats. Madison Moats, three ball is good. It's 15-14. Model has their first lead of the game. So, and these Moats girls, they're not afraid to throw it as soon as they, or to shoot it as soon as they come across half court.
Yep.
Daniels gets it into Barry. She loses it. Emma picks it up, drives in. Left-handed shot, no good. Rebounded by Roberts. Twilly gets it. Kiera's got her. Cuts her off. And then, almost a steal by Emma. And she almost had another one. Quarles comes up with it. Montana Moats with a three is good. And now it's 18-14.
Wow, we really got to stay on her.
Got to stay on both of those Moats. Megan Little, three of her own. No good off the back iron. Montana Moats with a rebound. Here she comes down the floor. One-on-one, Megan Little. Little sets up her charge. No call as Moats crashed into her. Rebounded by Evans. Now Kiera, one-on-one. Takes it in, lays it in, it's 18-16 model. So, Logan Adams knocks it away out of the hands of Madison Moats. And now Taylor Davis is in, and Logan Adams is going to come out. Oh, Taylor, that Nia Allen comes in, Taylor Davis is going to guard her. Barry is on, really almost had a steal. And that's going to be a foul on Ambria Daniels as she reached in on Montana Moats. And Moats is going to go to the line shooting a 1-1.
That's her second foul, Jeff.
So that's our 17th foul. And I think Model's got three.
I've only got two.
Well, I know Roberts has two.
Roberts
has two. She didn't got called for the illegal screen.
Right.
And then she got another one down here.
She didn't get the elbow. Remember, they gave that one to Brandy Jones.
So maybe they only have one then. No, they've got two. 15, Nia Allen has one.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they've got two. As Moats makes both of them. So, oh, I got you. You're right. Sorry. Megan Little with it. Gives it up to Taylor Davis in the corner. Back to Little. Three ball on the way. And hits the back of the line. Rebounded by Evans. And she puts it up and in. 20-18. Allen quickly down the floor. 3 minutes to go before the half. Allen goes around a little, and then that's going to be a foul on Kiera Berry. Nia Allen will go to the line shooting 1-1. That's our 18th foul, the only two for Model.
Wow.
Allen at the line shooting 1-1. Shot is up and good. 21-18. Second shot is good, 22-18. All right, Megan Little's going to bring it down. Twilly is on her, over to Emma Evans. Rebound on the way, short. And Emma gets her own rebound, gets it out to Ambria, all the way across to Megan. Megan drives in, gives it up to Emma, down on the baseline. And Ambria tried to get it inside of Kiera, stolen by Allen. Allen comes down the floor, gives it up to Twilly. Rebound on the way, no good. Rebounded by Davis. She gives it up to Little. Megan's going to bring it down the floor as Twilly's on her. Megan slips. Ambria Daniels right there to pick it up. Wow, Twilly tackled Ambria.
She certainly did.
Little picks up the ball. Barry, that's going to be a blocking foul on 32, Madison Moats. That's only the third foul.
Kind of lucky to get that call right there with everything going
well,
on.
Coach Sally Eccles of Model wanted a 10-second call, but whenever your player touches the ball, it knocks that away.
Yeah.
So the official gave it on 33. It should be on 32. Little gets it into Barry, right back to Little. And Bria sets a screen for Little. Gets it to Davis, over to Ambria. She's outside. Evans gets it down to Davis on the baseline. Inside to Ambria. Mismatches her and Nia Allen. And Ambria puts up a shot. Hits between the backboard and the rim. And then she just lost it out of bounds.
Yeah, I don't think she quite knew where her presence was under the goal. She's a little bit too far under right there.
Allen brings it down, drives in on Perry, and throws up
a prayer.
Just a prayer, and it goes in, 24-18, Model leads. Megan Little gets it to Evans. Back to Little. Takes a three, cut in. Went nice dish to Emma Evans. Great pass by Megan Little, and Emma lays it in, 24-20. Now Barry is on Allen in the man. And who's got most? Megan Little has Montana Moats. Allen can't draw a baseline on Barry. She comes back in, gets it knocked away by Davis, and then Moats picks it up. Little went for a steal. Madison Moats, three ball, no good. Rebounded by Evans. 1:05 to go before halftime. We trail by four. Good pick by Megan Little. Three ball by Kiera, no good. And Twilley's going to let it go out of bounds. So Kiera set her feet. It was a good shot, just right off the rim. So Model has come in with a good game plan. They're playing man-to-man on us, and but a very tough man.
Very physical. Very physical, both teams.
And they only have three fouls called on them, where we have eight. So Sierra Berry on Allen. Allen cannot make a move on Berry like she was earlier. Or she wasn't on Kiera. She was actually on Megan Little. And Megan Little's on Moats now. Allen loses her feet. Emma Evans tries to take it away, and they call a jump ball. Model tried to get a timeout.
Doing timeout right here in front of the rim.
So, but they call a jump ball. Jump ball is going to go to Model. So
they save the timeout.
Save them a timeout. They still get the ball. Megan Little is going to take a seat as Logan Adams came in. We trail by four. Twilley gets it in to Moats, who gives it up to Moats. So Madison gave it to Montana. We're at 20 seconds. Logan Adams is on Montana Moats. Emma Evans is on Madison mode. They're still dribbling out. 12 seconds to go. Twilley with the ball. Davis is on her. Madison Moats has it. She dribbles in, gives it to Montana. Montana drives in, and she goes right by, misses the layup as time expires, and it's 24-20 Model at halftime. Whew, we're going to take a 60 seconds, let Chris add everything up. We're going to be joined by Coach Vic Calhoun here shortly to talk about the big game he has tonight against the Model Blue Devils. We want to thank Blue Moon and A-Plus Storage, Family Savings Credit Union, Chick-fil-A, and Lewis Motors for sponsoring Rockmart Yellow Jacket Basketball. Because of them, we can bring you all this exciting action. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
Lewis Motor Company is the oldest car dealership in Rockmart. They have been serving Rockmart and the Polk County area for 56 years, providing quality used cars and great customer service before, during, and after the sale. Lewis Motor Company is proud to offer guaranteed credit approval while you wait. Give them a call today at 770-684-6694 or stop by and see our staff at Lewis Motor Company, 218 South Piedmont Avenue in Rockmart.
Your personal information is very important, and when compromised, can lead to big security issues. Don't trust your information with a here-today, gone-tomorrow company. Call somebody with reliability and stability in this community. Barnes Tax Service, 770-684-7556.
You're listening to Rockmart High School Basketball here on WZOT, 101.9 FM, AM 1220.
All right, we're back at the Rock as we're at halftime of the Lady Jackets basketball game against the Lady Models of Lady Blue Devils of Model. And Model leads 24-20. And, Chris, they've come in with a pretty good game plan. They've gone man-to-man defensively the whole time. And so we're not hitting our outside shots yet.
Yeah, they're definitely going to have a talk here at halftime. And hopefully I'm sure Coach Clark is seeing what we're seeing, and he's going to, you know, get some things straightened out right there during halftime.
All right, so leading scores for the Lady Jackets right now?
Kiera with eight.
Megan Little with 3, Logan with 3, Ambria with 2, and Emma with 4.
So there's the leading scores for Lady Jackets. So now we're joined by Coach Vic Calhoun. And, Coach, glad you join us here. He's got a big game tonight against the Model Blue Devils as they are tied with Chattooga atop the standings 10-1. We're one game behind them, 9-2. But, you know, last time we played them, we beat them at Model 61-54 back December 13th.
Yeah, I know. It seems like forever ago. There's a packed house here tonight. It's going to be a lot of fun. Two really good basketball teams. Anytime, the last few times we've played Model, it's been a 1 or 2 point game within the last minute. So I expect nothing different tonight.
Well, Coach, I'll tell you, you know, looking at it, we come in averaging 60 points a game, but in region play, we have the best offense in region play, averaging 67 points a game and only giving up 52. And really, that's only behind Model and Chattooga defensively. But we are, you know, far better than the two of them offensively as far as scoring points goes.
That's exactly right. That's our biggest focus here. 90% of our practice is honestly on our offensive end and just pushing the pace. And most of our defense, honestly, comes from our offense, kind of, backwards from the way a lot of teams practice. But, when teams try to match our pace, a lot of times their better players are in foul trouble or they're gassed and they just don't practice or play every day in practice at the speed that we like to play. And, that's our advantage. And Model's the absolute opposite. They want to slow it down and turn it into a half-court ball game, and that's what makes this matchup so much fun every year is it's two such contrasting styles of play, and it turns out to be a good ball game.
Yeah, and we know, they've got the big guy down low, Jabari Burge. He had 17 last time we played him at Model, but we expect to be able to handle him down low. You got Sherman Davis, you got Boozer, you got several down low that will be able to beat and bang with him tonight.
That's right. They're going to have a lineup with at least two guys that are 6'5 out there, and they really their starting lineup. They'll have three guys that are 6'3. Their fourth starter, I'm not sure who he'll be tonight. I've heard that they're going to go big, and they got another 6'3, and then they'll run a point guard out there that's 5'9 or so. So it's going to be really difficult for us to win the rebounding battle tonight. But I think if we do win the rebounding battle, or we can compete and come close to 50-50, then that gives us a good chance to win the basketball game.
Well, and I'll tell you, it sounds like to me, if they come out with those big guys, we're going to be looking to probably put some pressure on them defensively and look and see if we can be off and running and be able to outrun them to the goal.
Without a doubt. We spoke about it last week some, but we have to rebound in order to run. If we're taking the ball out of the net, then they get their defense set up, and it doesn't matter how fast we get down the floor, they're set and ready to go. So we've got to rebound the basketball, give them one opportunity on the offensive end, and then, push the ball as fast as we can down the other end of the floor before those big, long guys get time to get set. And, hopefully fatigue will play a role in the game tonight if we're able to rebound the basketball so that we can run.
Well, Tuesday night we're coming off a big win against Pepperell, 76-58. Model was playing Coosa. They come away with a win 60-58, so a 2-point win there for them. And what I would imagine was a pretty tough game for them playing Coosa, where you were able to rest some of your players, get some of your younger players in the fourth quarter as we had a 6-minute clock. No, we didn't have that. Was not that game. That was the girls' game. Had a 6-minute clock. Sorry, but you were able to get some of the younger guys in later in the game.
Yeah, I hope it pays off. Yesterday's practice, we were kind of light on their legs because I do think pace is going to be the factor in deciding the winner of today's game. The team that controls the pace is going to have a better chance at winning. And, hopefully we're sprinting up and down the floor and we turn it into a track meet.
Well, Coach, we know tonight's a big game. Like we said, we're one game behind them in the standings as they're tied with Chattooga atop the standings. Our two losses, of course, are to Chattooga. They have beaten Chattooga. We have beaten them. We're hoping for a win tonight. And at least that gives us the tiebreaker against them, so we would get the Susie. But then next week, Model's going to have to play Chattooga, so who knows what can happen there.
Yeah, it's funny. We could beat Model, and then Model could beat Chattooga, and everybody win the rest of their games, and we could end up in third. Or we could end up in first in that scenario. Or like you said, we could beat Model, and then if Chattooga gives Model another loss, then we would be second, and that would solidify us a spot in the state tournament. But at the end of the day, we don't control any of that other than what happens tonight. And, if we don't beat Model, we're looking square at third or fourth place. So, it starts tonight, and hopefully we give ourselves a chance to come out with a one or two seed.
Yeah, the biggest thing, we want to get that win tonight. And if we can get that win tonight, then tomorrow night at halftime of the girls' game against Cedartown, we can talk more about what's going to happen down the road if all that happens. First and foremost, we got to get this win tonight. And it's going to be tough, and it's going to be loud in here at the Rock tonight.
Oh, without a doubt. This is one of the biggest, probably the biggest crowd we've had all year. Definitely the biggest crowd since last year's region tournament final here against Chattooga. Again, like I said, the last few times we played these guys, it's been a one-possession game in the last minute. So it won't be any different tonight, I'm sure.
Yeah, and, they're still filing in. Our side is filling up quickly. I got more people here behind me than I've had all year long. And looking across at Model, their size, their lower section is starting to fill up, as well as some of the upper section. So it's going to be a good atmosphere. And then we got it two nights in a row, Coach, as Cedartown comes in tomorrow.
That's right. It's kind of been rivalry week for us. We played Pepper Tuesday. We got Model, who's been one of our bigger rivals in the last couple of years in the region, and then Cedartown, the traditional rival, all in the same week. So, it's a challenge emotionally for these guys, no matter win or loss tonight, to come in tomorrow focused and ready to play. But, anytime it's a rivalry game, the kids will be up for it, and it'll be fun.
Well, Coach, I tell you what, I'm looking forward to it. So far, this girls' game has been very entertaining, even though Model's got a four-point lead. But the Lady Jackets, they're right there, and they need one more win against either tonight or one of their games next week to guarantee them that two seed and, like we talked about, that automatic state playoff being in the state playoffs.
Yeah, that's right. That's really important. I was a part of a team back when I was at Villarica that we finished as the 9 seed in the 10-team region, ended up upsetting the number 1 seed after we won a play-in game, and that 1 seed hadn't lost a game all year. We had some guys healthy, and we just happened to shoot the ball well that night, and they didn't get to go to the playoffs. And they were ranked number 3 in the state that year, had a chance to win it all. So thankfully our region set up to where it honors our top 2 from the region from the regular season. So I hope the girls are able to clinch it tonight.
Yep, and we'll find out probably later next week exactly where that's going to be played at, and we'll let you know. Well, Coach Calhoun, thank you for joining us. Good luck tonight, and look forward to talking to you again tomorrow night as the Cedartown Bulldogs and Lady Bulldogs are coming in. The first JV game starts at 2, then 3:30, 5 o'clock, and 6:30. So it's going to be a good weekend, and hopefully a really good weekend, but going to be a long weekend for us as well.
That's right. Yep, I appreciate you guys.
All right, thank you, sir.
Yeah, Coach. Thank you.
All right, we're getting ready to go. Thank you to Coach Vic Calhoun as he joins us at halftime of all the girls' games. Talk about his boys, and they're getting ready to go as they've got a big game tonight. All right, Lady Jackets get the ball to open up the second half, and we've got our starting five. Well, Logan Adams is in there instead of Brandy Jones. Emma Evans, Kiara Berry, and Bria Daniels. Kiara with a shot at the free throw line. No good. Rebounded by Bria, and she puts it in. It's 24-22. So Adams, Little, Berry, Evans, and Daniels in as Moats drives in, loses it off her leg, and it goes out of bounds. And there's a turnover to the Lady Jackets. Allen, Quarles, Roberts, Moats, and Moats on the floor for the Lady Blue Devils. All right, Megan brings it down. Over to Evans. All the way across, Ambria cutting to the goal. She missed the shot. Roberts gets the rebound as Ambria picks up the loose ball, gets it to Kiara. She bounces off Nia Allen, and she puts it in, and we're tied.
And the boo-boos come out.
Yeah, well, Roberts didn't hit. And then there's a carry by Montana Moats as we wanted that earlier in the game and got it this time. So two straight buckets for the Lady Jackets, two straight turnovers for the Lady Blue Devils.
Now we got a tie ball game.
Now Ambria Daniels unable to hit that back door. Berry gets it, goes around, puts it up, misses the shot, rebounded by Moats. A little bit off balance was Kiara. And that one's right off the hands of Quarles, and that's three straight turnovers by the Lady Blue Devils.
Yeah, it looks like maybe Model might have, used some lotion or something during halftime. They've got slippery hands right now.
And Coach Eccles of Model calls a 30-second timeout. We'll take it with him.
Are you aware that untreated wood is highly susceptible to termite damage? Are you bothered by other pesky insects like bed bugs, ants, roaches, wasps, and hornets? Call Harrelson Termite and Pest Control for an inspection. They have the experience to handle your pest control needs. Call Harrelson Termite and Pest Control today to schedule an appointment.
Silver Comet Furniture, your one-stop shop for all your furniture and bedding needs. We carry brands such as Ashley, Catnapper, Liberty, and Jameson Mattress Company. At Silver Comet Furniture, 678-685-4320. 2000 Cedartown Highway in Fish Creek.
Now, more of Rockmart High School basketball here on WZOT.
All right, we're back. Rockmart gets it, brings it down. Kiera misses a shot, rebounded. Oh, wow, she walked. Yep, and they got her for a double dribble instead. So Madison Mose, that's four straight turnovers by the Lady Blue Devils.
She heard Emma coming in behind her, and that double dribble saved us a foul, too, because Emma was about to go to the ball.
Oh, yeah. Megan Little has it. Daniel sets the screen, and that's a carry by Megan Little. She wanted to pass and then just kind of turned it over. And still trying to figure out what kind of defense model set up in here. I can't see if they're in a zone or a man. It's tough to tell as quickly as we're moving the ball around. Moats all the way across to Moats. Megan Little's on her. Daniels, they get inside to Roberts. That's a walk on Roberts. Five straight turnovers by the Lady Blue Devils. Good defense by Andrea Daniels.
Forcing errors out now. That's a great job by our defense.
Our defense is speeding up their offense, and they can't handle that.
You're exactly
Andrea
right.
Daniels wide open. Logan Adams gets it back to Daniels. Ambria shoots a three. No good. Wow, Brooke Roberts hooked Emma Evans and kept her away from the ball.
Yes, totally.
Allen, we're in a man-to-man defense. Logan Adams lost her man, Madison Moats.
You cannot leave the Moats girls unattended, period.
Madison knocks down a three in 27-24, their first bucket of the half. Logan Adams has it, gets it into Barry. That's going to be a foul on, let's see which one. Looks like on 32, Madison Mose, that's her second personal. That's the first foul here of the half. And Kiara Berry is going to be at the line shooting two RW Laundry free throws. First free throw short off the front of the iron. She short-armed that one. You can see it.
She definitely like to have that one back.
Second free throw. Front of the rim as well. And Bria Daniels had the rebound, lost it out of bounds.
Yeah, it's very uncharacteristic of Kiara.
Is that her first free throws of the night?
Yes.
Okay, we're back to that one. Missed the first two, we'll make the rest of the
night. That's right.
So I'll take that right now. 5:15 to go third quarter. We trail by three.
Find the Moats, girls.
Montana Moats gets it to Madison, fakes a three, goes down the lane, puts up a shot, no good, rebounded by Little. Megan gets it, comes down the floor quickly. Gets it to Emma Evans underneath. Roberts with the block, and it's going to be out of bounds. And that's just a good job. Emma went right up with it, and Roberts just got her hand on top of the ball and blocked Emma's shot.
Emma's good size, but she only comes up to Roberts' shoulder.
Emma gets it into Kiara. Allen is on her as Model still in that man. Back to Adams. Three ball on the way. Looks good. It is. We're tying it at 27. You can see that one out of Logan's hand.
Yeah,
it looked good.
You called that one.
Allen goes down the lane against Kiara, and there's a turnover as Roberts went off her hand. Little gets it. Kiara's right there with her. She gets it to Kiara, and she lays it in. 29-27. Lady Jackets back with the lead. Moats gets it down to Montana Moats. Three ball short. She followed her shot. Got it. She got away with a carnival.
She sure did.
And she laid it in. But she followed her shot and got it. We're tied at 29. Megan has the ball. Quarles is on her. Gets it over to Emma. Emma on the left side, down to Logan. Logan back to Emma, over to Little. Inside to Barry, goes right at Roberts. He scores it, and the foul on Brooke Roberts. Barry gets to the line, shooting one RW Lottery free throw. Make sure you use those large commercial washers and dryers there. RW Laundry, 804 West Elm Street. Kiara's free throw is good, 32-29. The three-point play the hard way.
Yeah.
That, the old-fashioned way.
Yep, yeah, that free throw there, too, it wasn't flat like the first two.
Now we're going to put a little pressure in the backcourt. Allen gets it in to Moats. as Megan was guarding Montana in the backcourt. Somebody had to come up and get it. Allen gets it over to Madison Moats on the right side. Evans is on her. Emma Evans is on Madison Moats, and Megan Little's on Montana Moats. They tried to get it into Roberts, and a steal by Logan Adams. Now Megan Little brings it down. She's 2-on-5, her and Kiera. Megan goes to the goal. She gets hammered by Brooke Roberts, and that's going to be a foul, and that's her third personal, and Megan Little's going to be at the line shooting two RW Laundry free throws. Megan's first free throw is up, and it's the front of the iron, no good. We'd like to thank Harrelson Termite and Pest Control, Century Bank, Silver Comet Furniture, TNT Insulation, Totally Bronze Tanning Salon, Buy Low True Value Hardware, and Sherman Ross State Farm for sponsoring Rockmart High School Yellow Jacket Basketball, as Megan Little's second free throw is good. It's 33-29. We've got a four-point lead, 3:20 to go, third quarter. Allen gets it over to Madison Moats. Evans is on her. We're shilling that man-to-man. And that's a foul on Ambria Daniels as she reached in on Twilly, and that's her third personal. Moats is going to throw it in. Megan Little's right on her. And, Adams went in for a steal. Twilly has it all the way over to Quarles, or Twilly now. Deep three by Moats is good. Wow.
Wow.
Madison Moats with a 28-footer.
Wow.
And she knocked it down for three. It's 33-20.
Man, they put a lot of arcs on that ball, too. That's perfect.
33-32. And Bria gets it over to Logan Adams, down low to Emma. Emma inside to Barry. She shoots, scores off the glass. 35-32. That's a mismatch of Kiera Barry on Montana Moats.
Yeah, and if we can continue to capitalize on it, that's going to be huge.
Allen has it. Gives it up to Twilly. Twilly hits Moats cutting in over outstretched arm of Barry. And Barry blocked the second one, and Bria Daniels with a rebound. Barry has it. She's off and running. Wow. That was a forearm. And Barry right to the goal, and she scores. And we're going to get a timeout. Wow. A 30-second timeout by Andre Clark. And, wow, I cannot believe they did not call the forearm by Madison Moats. 30 seconds. We'll be right back.
Hey, Jacket fans. This is your old buddy Bill Shervesy, general manager of All-Star Motors here in Rockmart. At All-Star, we offer late-model pre-owned vehicles with guaranteed credit approval. Come drive your new pre-owned vehicle home today. That's right, today. Visit our web at www.allstarmotorco.com. We have that unforgettable phone number, 770-684-CARS. Remember, All-Star Motors, where every day is an All-Star Day, and go Jackets.
Now, more of Rockmart High School basketball here on WZOT.
All right, we're back. Kiera Barry took a forearm shiver, went right to the goal, laid it in. We're up 37-32. Willie has it. Daniels is on her. Coach Clark got a 30-second timeout to kind of have, get a little talk in. Daniels gets her hand in. Allen misses the layup. Barry off and running. There's a flop by Moats. Barry right down the goal lane. And, wow. Really flopped underneath. And Kiera Barry gets called for a charge. You kind of knew that was coming.
Yeah.
Anytime you play model, you almost expect some calls like this.
Yeah.
In basketball.
That was just an I'll show you.
Yeah, you just argued about that one, so we'll see. All right, Moats has it. Evans knocks it away, almost a steal, and almost another one. Allen has it. There is a steal by Emma Evans. She's off and running. She's going to take it coast to coast, but then she slows it down. Emma lost control. Wide open three. He scores! And it's 40-32. Lady Jackets with an 8-point lead, their biggest lead of the night. Coach Echols, you better get a timeout. As there's a deep three by Moats, rebounded by Little, and we're going to slow it down. 1:10 to go in the quarter. Logan Adams takes a three inside to Daniels. She puts it up. No good. Rebounded by Evans. No good. Rebounded by Barry. It's good. Two shots. It's 42-32. 10-point lead, Lady Jackets. And there's a timeout by Model. Lady Jackets with a 10-point lead. Hang on, Brian. 30-second timeout. We'll be right back.
A-Plus Store Solutions is your local Weaver's Portable Building and R&B Metal Structures dealer in Rockmart. We also sell dock kennels and a variety of trailers, including dump trailers. Get your portable building faster at A-Plus Store Solutions. We are located just a half mile south of Rockmart High School on Highway 113. Stop by and see Jim or give us a call at 678-883-2006.
Back in the rock. This Wolf Jeff Shaw. All right, we're back. Twilly throws it in to Allen. Back to Twilly. It's guarded by Daniel. She dribbles in. Out to Quarles. Quarles takes it in. Gives it up to Moats underneath. She hits the bottom of the rim. No good. Daniels with a rebound. Gives it to Bear. Right to the goal. She lays it in. 44-32. Lady Jackets pulling away. 30 seconds to go. Allen brings it down, kicks it back to Twilly, over to Moats. Deep three by Madison Moats, Montana Moats, and she scores. Cannot leave them open. Emma Evans takes it in. Little, right down the lane, floater, no good, rebounded by Twilly. At the buzzer, three, no, it hits the top of the goal is no good as Madison Moats had a deep three. It's 44-35. Lady Jackets lead by nine. We outscore them by 13 in the third quarter. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
WZOT Rockmart, W270CE Rome.
Come celebrate Tilly's Home Furnishings grand reopening. And what else we're going to have, Scooter?
Those birthdays!
That's right, Scooter. Derek's 49th birthday at Tilly's Home Furnishings, Saturday, January the 25th, starting at 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Tell them what all's going on, Scooter.
We're going to have bounce houses, hot dogs, store prizes.
Yes, we're going to have bounce houses, which is inflatables for the kids provided by K&R Inflatables. Weather permitting, WZOT Radio will be live on scene. Hey, Scooter, what do you want the people to do?
Come see T-Ball in Belfast. Come see Scooter. Best deal on a furniture and a recliner and propane. Tilly's Home Furnishings.
So you don't want to miss that exciting day, Saturday, January the 25th at 966 Cedartown Highway, Rockmart, Georgia, from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m.
Come see us. Ask the Scooter.
All right, back of the rock. Model gets the ball, open up the fourth quarter. Lady Jackets, 9-point lead. Allen with a floater on the baseline. And it's no good, rebounded by Evans. Evans gives it up to Little. Emma on the left side. Megan Little, top of the key, goes around Quarles. Three ball, Brandi Jones. It's good! 47-35. Lady Jackets with another 12-point lead. Three ball by Quarles, no good. Allen saves it into Moats. Back to Quarles. Quarles drives down the lane, gives it up to Roberts. Roberts gets bumped by Evans. She misses the shot, but she's going to go to the line to shoot two.
Who did they call that foul on, Jeff?
Caught it on Emma. Brooke Roberts with a free throw. She makes that one. So that is Emma's second personal. So we don't have anybody in foul trouble. Andrea's with three. Brooke Roberts makes the second one. 7:05 to go in the game. We lead by 10. Sierra with it as Montana Moats is on her. Three ball. Logan Adams wide open. No good. Rebounded by Brandi Jones. She puts it up. No good. Rebounded by Madison Moats. Allen brings the ball down the floor. Kiara Berry's on her. That's a moving screen on Roberts. They didn't call it. Three by Moats. No good. Logan Adams runs it down. She gets the rebound. Ahead to Megan Little. Oh, Kiara. Brandi Jones way down the floor by herself. Moats trying to pick up. I don't know what she's trying to do. She's playing defense with her body. deep three by Barry. Oh, in and out, no good. Rebounded by Madison Moses. Allen brings it down. Barry's on her. Deep three by Madison Moses. Good. 47-40. 6:10 to go.
I wouldn't want to be missing this one right now, Jeff.
No way. Evans has it inside. Down on the baseline. Brandy Jones couldn't catch it, and it's out of bounds. 6 minutes to go in the game. We lead by seven. Anna Claire Size, she's sitting at home sick. She just now got figured out how to tune us in. So, hey, Anna Claire, good. Glad you listened.
Hope you get better.
Yep, we look forward to seeing you. Deep three by Moats. No good. Barry off and running with the rebound. Moats just yelled at her. Allen tried to get in her way. Kiara missed the shot. Got a rebound. She scores and got hammered, and she's hurt. She hurt her wrist. She's getting helped up. She's up. She's going to shoot. She made the bucket as Brooke Roberts. Nope. 32. Madison Moats gets called for the foul.
I got her with three.
That's her third personal. And Kiara's going to go to the line shooting one. RW Laundry free throw. Logan Adams comes out. So now our original starting five. Barry, Little, Jones, Evans, and Daniels. Roberts, Moats and Moats, Allen, and Quarles on the floor for the Lady Blue Devils. 49-40, we lead. We'll see how that wrist is. Free throw, RW Laundry free throw is good. 50-40, Lady Jackets lead. 5:30 to go in the game. Allen with the ball. We're still in a man-to-man defense. Roberts trying to set a screen. Moats has Little on her. She turned it over again. Goes down around Little. Misses the shot. Rebound by Barry. She's off and running. She's one-on-one. The great pass to Emma Evans, and she scores. Give the assist to Kiara Barry and the bucket to Emma Evans. Has a timeout. Not a Lady Blue Devils. We lead by 12. 60 seconds. We'll be right back.
Here's a real tweet from a real Chick-fil-A guest. Meredith writes,
am I the only person who didn't know Chick-fil-A had mac and cheese? Holy game changer.
The secret's out now, Meredith. Is there anything you think the world should know about our mac and cheese?
What I really like about the mac and cheese is the oven-toasted, golden brown, cheesy top layer. It's savory, and it makes you feel really good.
That does sound amazing. Thanks, Meredith. Try the mac and cheese yourself at your local Chick-fil-A. Real Chick-fil-A guests paid for their testimonial.
Lewis Motor Company is the oldest car dealership in Rockmart. They have been serving Rockmart and the Polk County area for 56 years, providing quality used cars and great customer service before, during, and after the sale. Lewis Motor Company is proud to offer guaranteed credit approval while you wait. Give them a call today at 770-684-6694 or stop by and see our staff at Lewis Motor Company, 218 South Piedmont Avenue in Rockmart.
Now, more of Rockmart High School basketball here on WZOT.
All right, we're back in the Rock. Lady Jackets lead by 12. Allen with the ball. Gives it up to Montana Moats on the left side.
Our fans really getting into it right now.
She gives it up to Madison. That's going to be a foul on Brandy Jones. Wow. They call it in the act of shooting. That's going to be Brandy's third. I'm sorry. That's three on Brandy, and Bria has three, so really nobody in foul trouble for the Lady Jackets.
No, not here in the fourth period.
And we know Model doesn't have anybody in foul trouble. They haven't called enough fouls on them. First free throw by Madison Moats is good. Second free throw, no good. We didn't box out Montana Moats. She got the rebound. Gives it up to Madison. She missed the layup. Rebound by Daniels. Evans off and running, and we're going to slow it down as Roberts is on her. Gets it to Ambria over to Little. We're going to set up our offense. Megan out around half court, out around the B, out around the Yellow Jacket. Gives it to Ambria. They're just playing catch. We're going to keep it away. 4.5 minutes to go. Evans, Emma, just hold the ball till they come out on you. Emma's just holding it. Wait, now Roberts is going to come out on her and give it to Ambria. Ambria back to Brandy Jones.
Oh!
And Ambria left her spot, and Brandy threw it to her. And that's a turnover by the Lady Jackets. Model inbounds it, gets it to Madison Moats. She gives it up to Quarles. Quarles, not a deep threat from three, but both of Moats are. That's going to be a foul on Andrea Daniels as Madison Moats drives in throws it up, and it goes off the glass and in. 52-43, 4:07 to go in the game, and Moses is going to be at the line shooting one free throw.
That does put Andrea with four now, so she's got to be careful the next 4 minutes.
Well, you're probably going to see her come out here shortly as Moats hits the free throw. It's 52-44. Evans gets it in to Jones. Back to Ambria. They get it to Emmer, then to Kiera across half court. Kiera with Allen goes it, takes it to the basket and scores off the glass. 54-44, 3:50 to go in the game. Allen with the ball. Kiera's on her. Moats takes the shot.
Oh, come on.
Wow. That's a game it is. They call traveling. As somebody, one of the Lady Jackets got a handle, I think it was Ambria, and caused her to lose control. She regained control, but that's a traveling violation. Berry with the ball. She brings it across. Moats is on her. Moats, she goes around Moats. Floater, no good. Gets her own rebound. Oh, I thought she had her own rebound.
Yep,
ball's on the floor, and Bria picks it up. Now we're going to slow it down. Emma's holding the ball until somebody comes out on her. Now they come all the way across to Brandi Jones. Oh, then Allen tips it away from Evans. And Bria picks it up. That's a foul on Madison Moats. That's her fourth. That's going to be four. And the sub's going to come in as Twilly comes in. Quarles goes out.
That's her fifth team foul.
So five team fouls on Maul. Actually, Quarles is
four on her.
Quarles is going to stay in, and Madison Moats went out. And Bria gets it in to Kiera. Kiera right at Roberts. Roberts blocks her shot. Rebound by Evans. Evans shot. No good. Rebounded by Berry. Berry blocked again by Roberts. Little with the ball. Gets it to Jones. Back to Little. Little on the right side. Dribbles. Gives it up to Kiera. Kiera, three ball on the way. No good. It's short. Rebounded by Roberts. She gives it to Twilly. Twilly's going to bring it down to the floor. Twilly around Kiera, right down the lane. No good. Too hard off the glass. Rebounded by Moses. She picks it up. Gets it to Roberts. Reverse layup is good. 54-46. 2:40 to go in the game. We lead by eight. Mary's going to bring it down. Now, just stop right there, Kiera. And she is waiting on Montana Moats to come get her. Moats, she gives it up to Ambria, then to Emma. Ambria has it right at near half court. Roberts comes out, throws it up to Kiera. Kiera goes in, shot up. She scores! And the foul on Quarles. Kiera scores. We're up 10. She's going to shoot one RW Laundry free throw.
Very tough physical game right here.
So we know Model has 16 fouls now. How many for Rottmar?
We only got four.
All right. Kiera's free throw is short. Most with a rebound. Hits the floor. Did not get called. Twilly, three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebounded by Evans. Knocked away by Allen. That's going to be a foul on Nia Allen. And now Emma Evans is going to be at the line shooting a RW Laundry bonus. And Emma Evans will be shooting a 1-1.
Yes.
So we've only got 14 fouls. They have seven now. So we're going to be in the bonus the remainder, 2:04, and we lead by 10. Chris, I like our chances.
Yeah, we need to knock a couple down right here while we have the opportunity.
And we know with a win tonight, it locks up the 2 seed in the region. Emma Evans' first free throw is good. Her first RW Laundry free throw. Brooke Roberts is going to go out. Madison Moats comes back in.
Emma's having a great night.
Emma's second free throw is good. 58-46. We lead by 12. Allen gets the ball in, gets it across half court, 2 minutes to go in the game. Kicks it back to Montana Moats. She drives in, shot up, no good. Rebounded by Little. Her and Madison Moats, they tie up and they call a jump ball.
On the model.
So that's going to go to Rottmar.
Oh, Rottmar, good.
So our ball, 1:51 to go. Moats could have got her fifth right there. All right, Megan gets it into Kiera. She goes down the left sideline, right between three of them, wide open lane. She lays it up. We lead by 14, 1:40 to go. Do not let the Moats girl shoot a three. Madison all the way over to Twilly. Three ball on the way, air ball, no good. And Priya Daniels with a rebound, tries to get it to Evans, and it's off the knee of Twilley out of bounds to Rottmark. 1:32 to go in the game. Megan gets it into Kiera. And Bria sets a screen. And Moats, wow, that's got to be a foul. And it is. Twilley ran over Kiera. She landed on the ball. And Kiera jumps right up. She's going to go to the line shooting a 1-1. We lead by 14, 60-46. 1:25 to go in the game.
Getting physical down there. I mean, it's really a physical ball game.
And that's one where Kiera just stopped and Twilley kept going.
Yeah, couldn't stop for a moment.
And it looks worse
than it was.
It looks worse than it really is.
A little more intentional than it was.
Right. Kiera misses the free throw. Moats with a rebound gives it up to Allen. Two ball by Quarles, no good. And Emma just lets it go out of bounds. 1:14 to go in the game. We lead by 14. All right, Megan's model still in that full court press as Megan throws it into Embria. She sets a screen. Megan goes around it. She gets the ball down. Another trip by Moats, not called. And Montana Moats picks it up. Oh, I thought she was going to shoot. Twilley drives in, dishes off. Allen loses it. Moats picks it up, lays it in. Timeout with 55 seconds to go, 60-48. 60-second timeout by Model. We'll be back right after this.
At Century Bank of Georgia's Rockmart office, you'll find the reassuring blend of responsive, personal service with a wide array of accounts, technologies, loans, and more. And you'll find each delivered by a bank professional whose goal is to exceed your expectations of what a bank can be. We invite you to discover all we are today. Your local choice for community banking. Go Jackets! Century Bank of Georgia. Rockmart. We want to be your bank. Member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Who has time for laundry? R&W's Laundry, the cleanest laundromat in Northwest Georgia, is a full service 7 days a week laundromat with state-of-the-art washers and dryers. Don't want to wash? Let our friendly staff do it for you. Ball teams, churches, restaurants, and even wedding services are welcome to come to R&W's Laundry, proud sponsor of Jacket Basketball, located at 804 West Elm Street, Rockmart. And go Jackets.
All right, we're back at the Rock. 55.6 seconds to go. We lead by 12. Megan Little throws it in, gets it to Kiera. Kiera got around Montana Moats. Then she lost the ball, and then that's going to be a foul on Montana Moats. That's going to be the 10th team foul on Model. Kiera's going to be at the line shooting two RW Laundry free throws with 49 seconds to go in the game.
Yeah, it's just not... I think it's just now.
No, it's two. They said it's two. Sierra's first free throw is good. Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter now.
Second free throw, no good. Long rebound, rebounded by Allen. We lead by 13. They get it down the court to Twilley. Over to Quarles. Moats, three ball on the way, is good. 61-51, 37-36. Get it into Jones, up ahead to Evans. Just hold the ball across half court. Gives it up to Jones, over to Berry. As Moats reaches in, can't get it. Berry with a floater, no good, gets her own rebound. 22 seconds, just dribble out. Hold it, we're up by 10. Evans with the ball, over to Ambria. They're not trying to foul, they're just letting us run it out. As long as we don't throw it away. Kiera drives in. And she misses the shot, but she's going to get fouled by Quarles. 10 seconds to go in the game. And I think it's academic now.
Yep.
Kiera's first RW Laundry free throw, no good, off the front of the rim. And that's probably the one spot in this game that we did not do well, execute well, is at the free throw line tonight.
Yep, that's so exactly right.
She makes the second, 11-point lead. Twilley with a three, 4 seconds to go, and Sally Echols of Model takes a timeout, down by 8, 4 seconds. And this is kind of one of those, hey, I'm just going to call a timeout because I have it. So 30 seconds, we'll be right back.
Your personal information is very important, and when compromised, can lead to big security issues. Don't trust your information with a here today, gone tomorrow company. Call somebody with reliability and stability in this community. Barnes Tax Service, 770-684-7556.
Now, more of Rockmart High School basketball here on WZOT.
All right, we're back in the Rock. Jeff Sharp, Chris Wolf, 62-54. Lady Jackets lead, 4 seconds to go. Logan Adams going to throw it in. Models in the press. She gets it in to Megan. They don't try and foul. They reach, but don't foul. Megan just runs out the clock, and that's for the ball game. Lady Jackets win, 62-54 over the Lady Blue Devils of Model. And they lock up the 2 seed in the region. They still got a chance for a 1 seed. But we got to have 2 losses out of Chattooga. But a very physical game, but a good game. We're down by 4 at the half and then come back and win by 10. So we're going to let Chris add everything up. We scored 20 in the first half and 42 in the second half. So we're going to let him add everything up here, and we'll be back in 60 seconds to close out the girls' game and get ready for the boys.
Hey, Jacket fans, this is your old buddy Bill Shervsey, General Manager of All-Star Motors here in Rockmart. At All-Star, we offer late model pre-owned vehicles with guaranteed credit approval. Come drive your new pre-owned vehicle home today. That's right, today. Visit our web at www.allstarmotorco.com. We have that unforgettable phone number, 770-684-CARS. Remember, All-Star Motors, where every day is an All-Star Day, and go Jackets.
What kind of cake will they serve at your retirement party? Chocolate? Red velvet? Well, go ahead and call the bakery, because whether you plan to retire in 15 years or 50, a State Farm agent can help you take charge of your retirement and help make it seem like, well,
a piece of cake.
Sherman Rawls State Farm Insurance, 122 East Elm Street in Rockmart. Call 770-684-3500. Email him at sherman@shermanross.net. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Neither State Farm nor its agents provide tax, legal, or investment advice. Consult your own advisor regarding your particular circumstances.
Freeman Harris Funeral Home, the funeral home that has been providing a strong arm for our friends and neighbors to lean on for the past 76 years. We are proud of the young folks of our community and wish for them success on the field and off. Freeman Harris Funeral Home, Rockmart's very own.
Now back to the action of Rockmart High School basketball here on WZOT.
All right, back in the Rock, Jeff Sharp, Chris Wolf, as Lady Jackets come away with a 62-54 win over the Model Lady Blue Devils in a hard-fought physical game tonight here at the Rock. Chris getting a drink of water for you. He's still adding everything
up. I think I got it all added up. For the Model Blue Devils, of course, the two Moats girls, Madison Moats had 21, Montana Moats had 17. For the Lady Jackets, Kiara Berry had top of the box with 34, followed by Emma Evans with 11, and Bria Daniels had 4. Logan Adams had 6. Megan Little had 4. Sandy Jones had 3.
All right, well, the Kiara just kind of took over coming out at halftime as we scored 42 points in the second half. We trailed by 4, and, you know, really, that third quarter is really what did it, as we, you know, really pulled away, had a 10-point lead after being down by 4 and outscored them by 14.
Yeah, Coach Clark evidently went in and had a good talk, made some adjustments, settled them down a little bit, and the second half looked a whole lot different than that first half.
Well, we saw Kiara at the free throw line. We would get the ball inside to her, and I tell you, where Model really made their mistake, is most would go for the steal
and leave
Kiara one-on-one with Brooke Roberts, and she just took her right to the goal and beat her all night long.
Yeah, just beat her with the footwork. And, you know, Roberts was a whole lot taller, but just not the athlete that Kiara Berry is.
All right, so the Lady Jackets come away with a 62-54 victory, so we're going to shift gears, and I'm going to switch pages here. We're going to go to the boys, as the Rockmart Yellow Jackets and the Model Blue Devils in the boys' game. This is going to be a really good game. Last time we were there, we won 61-54, and Model is tied at 10-1 atop the standing in the region. We're at 9-2, just a game behind them. And we talked to Coach Calhoun at halftime and talked about how Rockmart is the leading scorer in the region play as far as points and average, as we score 67 points a game, give up 52. Model scores 62, gives up 50 in region play. Overall, we score 60, give up 53. They score 59, give up 48. And we know they got some big boys inside, so we're going to be beating and banging. We really got to crash the boards. And we got to hope Ty Floyd, Tyler Rowland, Cruiser, all of them have their outside shot down tonight.
Yeah, and you heard Coach Calhoun talk about the differences in play between both teams and how the cumulative effect of those differences turns into just one heck of a ball game between two great ball teams. So we'll see two different approaches tonight, and hopefully I'm sure we're going to see a great ball game.
Well, we know the Jackets are led by Juke Boozer at 13.5 points a game. Tyler Rowland, just over 10 points a game. But then you got Javen Watley at 10 points. But then Sherman Davis, Ty Floyd, Ja'Kari Clark, all with anywhere from 7.5 to 8 points a game as well. So, those six young men for the Jackets are going to have to do it. Of course, we know last time we played Model, Javen Watley wasn't there.
That's
and
right.
He's there tonight, so and it's going to make a difference here tonight. And so I'm looking around to make sure. I saw him here, but I heard a rumor, and it must be true. Javen's not playing tonight. So So we knew he missed the beginning with his knee, and this one just a little, just a little discipline issue that he's got to go through that he's dealing with. But we know he'll be back probably not tomorrow, but he'll be back next week. So wishing Javen all the luck there. I hope he gets everything straightened out. But with the Jackets that we have, feel really confident that they can do the job once again against the Model Blue Devils.
Yeah, and this crowd tonight, Jeff, it's almost a playoff atmosphere, or it really is a playoff atmosphere. You know, this is a huge crowd on both sides. Just can't say enough for either school's representation here tonight.
Well, and I'll tell you, momentum in the girls' game was huge, as Model had the momentum going in at halftime. They led by 4, and their crowd was really getting up and, cheering them on, but then that outscoring them by 14 in the third quarter really kind of shut them all up. They tried to make a run, but then we just pushed it right back out. We pushed it right back out to double digits and ended up running away with it and winning by 8. And I think 14 was our biggest lead. So, all right, Brian, we're going to kick it back to you for about 2 minutes. Let us get some water and catch our breath. And we'll be back to talk a little bit more about this boys' game and get ready for the starting lineup. So we'll be back in 2 minutes.
Come celebrate Tilly's Home Furnishings grand reopening. And what else we're going to have, Scooter?
Those birthdays!
That's right, Scooter. Derek's 49th birthday at Tilly's Home Furnishings, Saturday, January the 25th, starting at 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Tell them what all's going on, Scooter.
We're going to have bounce houses, hot dogs, store prizes.
Yes, we're going to have bounce houses, which is inflatables for the kids provided by K&R Inflatables. Weather permitting. WZOT Radio will be live on scene. Hey, Scooter, what do you want the people to do?
Come see T-Ball in Belfast. Come see Scooter. Best deal on a furniture and a recliner and propane. Tilly's Home Furniture.
So you don't want to miss that exciting day, Saturday, January the 25th at 966 Cedartown Highway, Rockmart, Georgia, from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m.
Come see us.
Who has time for laundry? RW's Laundry, the cleanest laundromat in Northwest Georgia, is a full-service 7 days a week laundromat with state-of-the-art washers and dryers. Don't want to wash? Let our friendly staff do it for you. Ball teams, churches, restaurants, and even wedding services are welcome. That's R.W.'s Laundry, proud sponsor of Jacket Basketball, located at 804 West Elm Street in Rockmart. And go Jackets!
A-Plus Store Solutions is your local Weaver's Portable Building and R&B Metal Structures dealer in Rockmart. We also sell dock kennels and a variety of trailers, including dump trailers. Get your portable building faster at A-Plus Store Solutions. We are located just a half mile south of Rockmart High School on Highway 113. Stop by and see Jim or give us a call at 678-883-2006.